Okay, let's recap what you've taught us so far, Ellen. For the past 13 years, you've been trapped in a nightmare dimension called the Dark Place.
Yeah.
It's like New York, but it's not New York. And can be reached from the bottom of Cauldron Lake, but it's not really under the lake. And after all this time, you've managed to get out.
Yeah, yeah.
But so has your evil doppelganger, Mr. Scratch, or is it the Dark Presence?
Both. It's interchangeable. He's Scratch when he looks like me, but he can change into this other form.
And Scratch, the Dark Presence, wants to rewrite the world in his own image.
Which would be in your image, as he looks just like you.
And turn the world into a fucking nightmare.
During Deerfest, which is scheduled to take place in a couple of days. You got out of the Dark Place by writing a novel, the pages we've been finding. But your double edited it into a horror story that's now changing reality, taking over people,
yeah.
Making them crazy, bringing the Dark Place to Bright Falls.
Yes, fiction coming in contact with the Dark Place can change reality. The story is coming true, soaking into everything, like darkness when night falls. But last time it...
This will be back in 2010.
Yes, last time it didn't happen all at once. The story came true bit by bit as it unfolded. And that Dark Presence was still bound to the lake. I stopped it before it got the ending it wanted. Before it broke free. Based on that, there's still time.
Which brings us to your magical light switch.
The clicker. Magical doesn't quite cover it. Scratch wants it to bring about his ending. That can't happen. If I can get the clicker, I can send him back to the Dark Place, make all this shit go away. Look, I know it's batshit crazy. My memory is full of holes, and I'm not sure how much I can trust. It's like a half-forgotten dream.
Mr. Wake, Alan, we've seen our share of batshit crazy in the past 24 hours. What I want to know is, why am I? Why are we written into the story?
I think I saw you. Or a vision of you in the Dark Place. I think you helped me reach out and escape somehow. With that in the story, Scratch would have edited it to get to you. To hurt you. We are all in danger.
It's insane. And there's so much of it. Have you ever heard of the Cult of the Tree?
Creepy bunch. In the habit of wearing deer masks, performing murder rituals, victims turning into monsters possessed by darkness, possibly inspired by a horror story written by a certain author. Ring any bells?
The cult. Yes. Yes. They have the clicker.
If the cult has the clicker, does that make them Scratch's followers? How are you so certain they even have the clicker?
They could be working for Scratch. I don't remember. It's all confused.
Alan, if I'm gonna act on this information, you need to be honest with me.
Yeah, of course.
Is he confused? Or is he hiding something? Wake said the cult has the clicker. How does he know?
The writer is the reader. The next chapter, the next chapter, the next chapter. Keep the pages safe, the dark shining of the words.
Wake is hiding pages. That's how he knows the cult has the clicker. Wake has a double, Mr. Scratch. Where is he now?
A cloud of wrath wears my face, the dark place in your place, scratching out my body of work.
Scratches here, in Washington. He's hunting Wake. Scratch looks just like Wake. Why?
Don't wake up the dreamer if your life is a dream. I swam to the shore, but the water is rising.
Wake and Scratch are clearly connected. Maybe Scratch got out because Wake did. Or vice versa.
Okay, Mr. Wake. I know you have more pages of the manuscript on you.
You don't understand how vital these pages are. They're the only way I can know what's coming.
You're not the only one trying to solve this. This is our job.
Okay. Here. Now, this is all I have. Be careful with them.
Inside the trailer, at the outskirts of Watery, Saga had seen Wake's fabled clicker for the first time, in the hands of the Cult of the Tree. A cultist stared at her. She drew her weapon. Standing inside the trailer, at the outskirts of Watery.
Wake has more information. I need to keep questioning him.
Wake just gave us a lot of information, but this clicker,
Seems like a good place to start. If we find that, then we find the cult. Yeah. The cult of the tree has the clicker Wake told me about. They're a part of all this. Doesn't make sense. The pages we've been finding are from a horror story called Return, written by Alan Wake. And the contents of this book are coming true. Why couldn't it have been a romance? Right. No. Think. It's all on the page. The clicker, the cult. Okay, I'll head to Watery and find this trailer. Casey, you stay here and keep an eye on Mr. Wake.
Got it.
No, you need me there.
No dice, pal. This is an FBI investigation, and I don't see a badge on that flannel.
Hi, welcome.
Okay. Past favorite Deerfest floats. Go.
The yarn puppet monstrosity.
The stuffed moose and squirrels one.
No, thank you. Those beady dead marble eyes still give me nightmares.
Hello, and welcome to
Friendly and available to children of all ages.
Just like her coffee.
It won't open.
So, take a sip of her Oh Dear Diner organic coffee and let the adventure begin! Hold on for dear life on the Espresso Express!
Tammy tapped her pen on her notebook. Alan Wake had ridden this same ferry into town when he arrived. This was his entry into Bright Falls. His first steps across the threshold. She wrote that down. She always found it helpful to walk in the victim's shoes, do what they did, see what they saw. It added great color to the book. Tammy felt raindrops on her face. God, again? She pulled up her hood. The rain just kept coming. She missed New York. So far, this hadn't been the simple research trip she pictured. First the incident at the lake, then the fight with Ed. It's not surprising tempers got hot. They were both on edge after what had happened. Tammy had said some things she regretted. She looked out over the harbor. A chill passed through her. She hoped Ed wouldn't do anything stupid.
You wrote these pages in the dark place. So why are we finding them here?
I think I wrote them. I remember writing an endless amount of pages. When this happened before, the pages were being sent from the dark place to help me. Maybe the same thing is happening here.
That's all for now, Mr. Wake. Thank you for your cooperation.
a dark presence that stopped me. I had seen the title page of another manuscript, Return. I didn't remember writing it, but it felt familiar, important. I had to find it.
FBI agent.
I would write a new draft of initiation to reach Parliament Tower using another murder site. Scratch was reaching out from the dark place to get Alice. She was out, but still in danger. Forgotten. I knew how this worked now. I could take control, no more surprises.
What demons he wrestles with in the dark hours of the night. Together with our house band, the divine old gods of Asgard, we have created something special. The song is called Herald of Darkness. I like to call this next segment the story of the journey of Alan Wake, the musical.
It could not be opened on the side.
You grew up nice and sheltered with mama's pretty stories and your own made up theories.
And mama gave me a magic clicker. Well, yes, I think it's true and fair to say.
chilling thrillers of hard-boiled killers became bestsellers. It was all too much, I had to get away.
Thank you.
That was pretty good. A vision.
Such a dark place, am I trapped in here? Is this real? I cannot remember. There was a manuscript, it held a key. A vicious cycle I must not surrender to. Echo seems to seek out again and again until I figure it out to bring this song to its end. Is there any way out to bring this song to its end?
And I thought this place couldn't get any stranger.
Champion of light, herald of darkness, lost in the tomb.
It was all about me. This performance the Dark Place was putting on. But I had no control over it. I knew how utterly lost I was. The city was not real. I was limited to the confines of the dream. The payphone was ringing again. The mystery caller was back at it. I had to find out more. I needed to answer the phone. Last time the caller pointed me in the right direction.
Alan Wake? Do you know who I am?
How the fuck could I?
I'm not a paparazzi.
You keep jerking me around, refusing to tell me who you are.
You remember? You... Oh, fuck me. Alan, listen. Tell me, how much do you remember? Did you visit Parliament Tower? Did you find anything there?
Yeah. Alice is in danger. Scratch is reaching out to her, and there's another manuscript. Not initiation, return. I saw the title page. I don't remember writing it.
Return? Oh man, this is what we're after. The Scratch can't have it. Our survival, the survival of the fucking cosmic everything depends on this. Come to me. Ocean View Hotel. I left my room key for you. It's right there on the payphone. Remember, the Dark Place works in loops and rituals. If the waves keep pushing you away, you just need to find another way in. We go with the flow of this ocean. Catch you soon, brother.
The Ocean View Hotel. A suspicious invitation to a shady meeting. Right on the money for the hard-boiled genre the whole city was built upon. The Ocean View Hotel. my destination. A loop that delivered me back to the street. What did the mystery caller said? If the waves keep pushing you away, you just need to find another way in. With only dream logic to lead me to the hotel, I looked to the neon signs for guidance. The story I was building was fragile, constantly under attack. There was no time to waste. The Dark Presence was only a step behind me. Poisoning me with darkness. I had to find a way to escape before it was too late. Too late again. I could see the Ocean View Hotel. I was getting close. Pipes affected where the door led to.
Stay here for too long. You'll end up a lost soul haunting the streets and alleys, a faded out shadow glimpsed by some other poor bastard on his way toward the same fate. Your broken dreams become a broken mirror, and the twisted reflection staring back at you with all the pent-up anger, regret, guilt, and shame was the monster you could never get away from.
Thank you.
Barman, you caught my eye. I could use that shotgun. The room was empty except for the projector. More games. Was the film a message waiting to be played?
This temple of shadow and mist. There's a window in the floor and a door in the ceiling. There's no knowing. Am I standing still or running or kneeling?
You're the one who's been calling me.
Indeed. I'm Tom Zane. Welcome to the House of Zane.
The poet, the diver. You look like me, how the hell?
Or maybe you look like me, you handsome devil. The diver was a beloved character I played in one of my films. I'm a filmmaker, a celebrated auteur.
I need answers. Why is return so important? What?
You always get worked up like this. Come on, I'll fix you a drink. We're in this together. Two artists collaborating, remember? Crafting the keys to our escape. Your magnum opus, Return, and its companion piece, my film. Sharing our life-altering visions, a melding of higher minds. Dreaming up our transcendental work of art. Here, in this room. In this room, in this room, in this room, in this room, in this room. And that is how the magic happened.
Enough of this bullshit. Alice is in danger. I need another murder site to go further. Back to Parliament Tower. Scratches!
Your wife is safe back in the real New York. But Scratch is reaching for her through an overlap. Return is the key to escaping the dark place. You need to get it before that freak does. There's a murder site here in the hotel. Let the waves of your writing carry you there.
Hello?
They're on to us. If anyone asks, you were never here.
Thomas Zane had ended our talk in what felt like a paranoid fit. I had what I needed from him. There was another murder site in the hotel to guide me further toward my escape. I had to write my way to it.
whispers from the police radio kept me awake at night. The word through the ether. A murder in the backdrop of a play featuring a murder cult. How meta can you get? He said, looking knowingly at the camera. I could sense the cult of the word in this, and their leader, Mr. Scratch. Rumored to be Alan Wake, the writer who'd gone missing years before.
The hotel was a perfect setting for a Casey story. I was on the right path. I would start at the entrance lobby. The entrance hall set the mood where everyone had come in. The victim, the murderer, the detective. An idea, clear as a vision, waited for me here.
That's me. Our performance of the cult was cursed from the pre-show ritual on. The cult is an immersive theatrical experience.
You're gonna have to walk me through what that means.
Immersive theater. A play where the audience can participate, spread across this hotel.
The plot board was empty again.
So you were the director of this play?
Yeah, that's me. Our performance of the cult was cursed from the pre-show ritual on. The cult is an immersive theatrical experience.
You're gonna have to walk me through what that means.
Immersive theater. A play where the audience can participate, spread across this hotel. The cult is a legend. The only written copy of the manuscript lost, the play is passed on as oral tradition between theater companies. Each company only performs it once. The play was said to have special power. You were like kids playing with a Ouija board. And when you call for the devil, he will come.
The pre-show ritual. That's it. Set it up. Start from the beginning. The plot board was empty again. The room at the end of the corridor was closed off. It felt significant. Something terrible would happen there. Couldn't get in. I was missing something. Was empty again. I needed to... The prop room had been changed from room 104 to room 225. The troop were busy building their own Wicker Man, where they themselves would be sacrificed.
Existing in a countless number of parallel realities. Sometimes a quaint small town. Sometimes a hulking metropolis. Different every time we set upon the road that leads us there. And yet, like a half-remembered echo of a fading dream. Always familiar. These are the stories that take place.
was locked from the other side. I didn't have the key. The ballroom would be the stage of a key scene in the play. The plot board was empty again. I needed a new draft back. The cult in the play was called the Cult of the Tree. With their deer masks, they were the backwoods echo of the Cult of the Word's urban horror. I needed to find the key. This is where they gathered before the play. This is where it began. Was empty again. I needed a vision. Another idea.
Ritual to lead you on.
Why set up a play in a hotel? Why this hotel?
Because the rent is cheap? No. The ocean view was perfect for this. It's set to be haunted. Dark stories about murder, death, suicide. Supposedly, an actual cult once performed an unspeakable ritual to summon something in the ballroom. Did we summon the same thing? Tapped into something horrifying? It seemed like it was part of the play, but it wasn't. Does that sound crazy?
You don't want to ask me about crazy, kid.
A haunted hotel. Yes. That's a trope for a reason. The plot board was empty again. I needed a new draft back at the beginning. I couldn't get in. I was missing something. The plot board was empty again. I needed a new draft back at the beginning.
Yes, this ritual was to lead you on. The brand will meet him.
It's getting real, all right. I recognize my writer's room on the stage. I almost dreaded the ideas this would conjure up.
Nice set you got here. What was the scene in this room?
Well, this is what we call the writer's room. In the play, it's where the devil rewrites reality whilst God is asleep. The devil was our star role. I got a big-time celebrity to play him, and he was method acting the role to perfection. He never broke character, always wore the cult mask. His name was scratched out on the posters.
Mm-hmm. And who was this mystery celebrity? Let me guess, Alan Wake?
I wish I could tell you, but turns out there were masks upon masks. Whoever he really was, shit got weird when he was around. Some of the crew joked that we'd actually hired the devil to play himself.
Mr. Scratch is the devil. He was born to play the role.
I had to agree with Casey on that.
Make you
darkness and suffering! Words down your throat.
The plot board was empty again. I needed a new draft, back at the beginning, but closer to my goal. This thread would create something terrible in the scene, but it's what the story needed. Not my writing. This is Scratch mocking me. The scene here had changed. This was not the ritual murder site I was looking for. This had just been an appetizer before the main course.
Alan Wake.
The devil walked through the hotel, dragging the whole place to hell with him. Was draped in blood. I felt the presence of a new idea here.
Stayed in the hotel. Asking around at reception got me a room number. 666. He had requested that room, specifically. The devil had a sense of humor. Or he really didn't. It was funny either way. According to the director, the actor hadn't mingled with the rest of the cast. He had only come out for the play. And always in character.
Scratch had been here. I could sense his presence lingering in the room. I was about to have another killer idea.
Let's talk about Falcon. Let's talk about the murder victim. The lady who was killed in the climax of the play.
The leading lady. Oh, it was an honor to get to work with her. A grand dame for sure. She went back a long time. Kept insisting she had seen the long-lost original script of the play. She'd been with this mysterious writer, his muse. That was her role in the play. The muse.
She was staying in room 108, where the murder happened.
The set of the final scene, right. The devil comes, an unstoppable force crashing through the hotel through each scene, executed with devastating mastery. And all leading up to him, meeting his muse. It turns out he knew her. He had only joined the play to get to her.
To murder her.
You again. Had come for me, drawn to the story I was writing as it grew darker. The muse was the murder victim. The final scene took place in room 108.
Asking too many freaking questions. I've had enough of that. I've had enough of that freaking gumshoe dick asking too many freaking questions. Not letting us proper police take care of it.
This is our chance to make the powers that be happy. We'll be set for life. Part of the inner circle.
Well, amen to that, partner. I like it. And so will the fraternity, the club, the word. Our dear friends with many names. The way I see it, it was a lone nut job. A junkie out of his mind on some fancy new designer drug.
Open and shut case. All we gotta do now is dump the evidence from room 108 in the usual place in the alley.
This was the murder site. There was a record at the bottom of the bathtub, beneath the body. Somehow, it was important. Another step. Somehow, I was closer to home. Closer than ever before. It's you again. The FBI agent. Saga Anderson. I'm closer now. I can feel it. You helped me get closer to escaping.
Wake? Are we still trapped? Yeah, the clicker. We can feel it.
You know about the clicker? It can help us. I destroyed the dark presence with it last time. You can help. You can find it. You must find it.
I can get it to you. I have to understand. Did you write down the story?
Alice is in danger. I have to stop Scratch. I have to find a return. I need to get back to my apartment. I'm writing a story to get through. Initiation. It's the only way.
The story.
You can do that.
You can write our name.
It lasted only for a moment, like two planets passing in orbit. Saga Anderson was helping me go deeper. Closer to escape, somehow. I had to trust her. Parliament Tower. I had to get back to my apartment, my study. I had to find the manuscript of return.